The head of the Indianapolis Fraternal Order of Police is criticizing what he calls a broken system. And new tonight, he's taking aim at the number of offenders wearing electronic monitoring bracelets.
Yeah, he says they should be in jail. It's pretty clear. Fox 59's Nick McGill shows us what changes he's demanding tonight. Nick?
That's right, guys. Rick Snyder calling out the county's electronic monitoring system in a series of tweets this morning. But tonight, the head of the community corrections program is responding.
We're swirling the drain here, and nobody wants to admit it.
And unless we start having some tough conversations, Rick Snyder says it's only going to get worse. Today, the Indianapolis FOP president decrying the use of the county's electronic monitoring system in a series of tweets.
So the relief valve is now clogged up. You know, being overutilized, and there's no additional relief valve.
Currently, Marion County has more than 4,000 offenders on electronic monitoring. That's more than double any other individual city's program in the country. A result, Snyder says, of an overcrowded jail and a catch-and-release system giving cash bonds to those who should be locked up.
And so it gets back into the whole catch-and-release concept, and it also drives back this lack of accountability, which emboldens and empowers many of the people who are creating the violence in our community.
Snyder also points to the amount of those on electronic monitoring who continue to commit crimes or ditch their bracelets altogether. But the head of the county's community corrections says there's a disconnect between what electronic monitoring once was and what it is.
But an ankle bracelet, much like a cash bond, will not prevent a crime.
Tyler Boma says electronic monitoring is often used and thought of as an alternative to incarceration, but it's not. Rather, a tool they use for the bigger picture, getting at crime's root causes.
We need to change the thought process that this is a program in and of itself. This is a tool to be used in a bigger program.
Boma says it should be used for the people that they can help turn their lives around, not for the people the county doesn't have space for in jail.
We're not in the business of collecting debts to society. We need to be in the business of helping people not commit more crimes.
Both men agree the entire system needs help, not just any one program.
Now, Snyder and the Marion County Sheriff say a big part of this problem that's feeding into all of this is the Marion County Jail being forced to house hundreds of state prisoners. They say if they had those beds free, there would be far fewer offenders caught and released, hoping to provide some relief to the entire system. Dan?
All right, thank you.